Chaves in the black, Krnjic in the blue. Front kick early from Bosnian Steel. Trying to dig the balls of the foot into the midsection. Good defense there against the high kick from Bruno, and again a front kick from Krnjic. Nice timing early on from the Bosnian.
Up, up, up. No holding, no holding.
No clinching under kickboxing rules, no elbows either. Krnjic drills that stiff left hand out of that southpaw stance.
Krnjic is looking confident. He's coming forward, throwing that left hand.
Krnjic likes to really sit down on that power hand. Body shot there from Chaves. He's in orthodox stance.
Bruno needs to get that head moving. You know, that's what gave him the nickname Muhammad Ali. So I'd like to see him start moving that head and start putting some combinations together.
Inside leg kick a little too high on the thigh there. Maybe just clip the bottom of the cup of Bruno Chaves. Krnjic edges forward. Misses with the two there to Chaves. High kick from Chaves. Krnjic returns the favor. Enjoying the front kick so far, and there's a nice round kick to the back leg from Krnjic. Fires the front kick again. That time Bruno saw it coming.
Krnjic is moving really well early on, utilizing the kicks well, setting up that left hand. I'd like to see Bruno earn some respect, maybe start going after that lead leg, start working those inside leg kicks, but he's also got to let his hands go.
Outside leg kick from Krnjic, scoring points.
Watch out, low, all right?
And again, another low blow there from Krnjic. A little recovery time here for Bruno Chaves to shake everything back into place. But this has been an impressive start so far, Dragon, from Ahmed Krnjic.
Yeah, Krnjic is moving really well, moving like a middleweight out there, utilizing all the different weapons.
You know what, the kick itself was well placed, but then I think on the retraction, he brought the foot down and must have just clipped the cup, the front of the cup of Chaves. Nothing too serious, but indeed an illegal connection.
And it was the second time, you know, he got warned the first time, so he looks a little bit frustrated.
Chaves will be allowed the duration of a round if he needs it. That is 3 minutes, but I think he's okay to go on here. And Olivia Cost, rightly so, questioning Ahmed Krnjic. Krnjic edging forward, look for the front kick. Look for that left hand down the center. Jab two from Chaves. Chaves just hasn't found any rhythm yet. He's on the outside here. You see Krnjic cuts off the movement, cracks that back leg. There's the front kick from Krnjic. He's been reliant on it. The lead leg front kick. Then goes to the lead quad.
But Krnjic is respecting the power that's coming back from him from Bruno. He's really not letting go a lot of the combinations. He's just kind of throwing one shot here and there.
High kick there, scooped away nicely from Krnjic. Wilds uppercut off the right hand of the Bosnian, throws the front kick. There's one in return from Chaves. Chaves hands are low. Chop blocking left hand. Nicely done from Krnjic to end the round. Don't forget, three judges circle side scoring on a 10-point must system. Who do you have winning the first round? Well, the mood has changed inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium because our main eventers are arriving. There's the champion, Hiroki Akimoto, in his first defense of the Bantamweight Kickboxing World Championship tonight. And he will take on a man with over 400 fights. The great Pet Denong Pet Fergus, the number three Bantamweight Kickboxing contender, goes for the gold in our main event. Do they need to wake Chaves up a little bit here? Need some more output from the big man. Very good opening round for Krnjic.
Yeah, in the last 30 seconds, Chaves seemed to come alive. You know, I think the groin shots maybe kind of invigorated him, made him push a little bit more, wanted to get something back.
Second of three. There's a nice right hand to open up here from Bruno Chaves. Should continue with that right hand. It's always been public enemy number one of a southpaw. For Chaves to get his lead foot on the outside of Krnjic's lead foot and throw the right hand down the center. Nice round kick there from Krnjic.
Yeah, I like how Chaves is just kind of being a little bit more aggressive here, but I like the way that, you know, Krnjic is throwing that left leg kick, right? And he's attacking the back leg of him, and he's also going to the body as well with it.
Krnjic with a front kick. It's been one of the prime weapons of both legs so far tonight for Bosnian Steel. Chaves throws first on that occasion with the right hand. Edges forward the Brazilian, throws the right again. Body shot there from Krnjic, and there's the front kick again. Just parried away though from Chaves. Front kick up high there from Krnjic. Chaves checks the low kick. Jab two from the Brazilian.
Yeah, you can see that Chaves is almost waiting for Krnjic to do something, right? There he is.
Point strike again.
Going low again. It happens often when one fighter is southpaw, one fighter is orthodox, and you're throwing a lot of those lead leg kicks, right? You're going inside of the thigh. You just go a little bit high, but Krnjic is also throwing push kicks as well that are catching Bruno, you know, down low.
Counter left, went for a high step-up knee there. Did Krnjic, had the right idea. Bruno, right hand. Little sloppy there from Chaves. Needs to tighten it up now. Krnjic goes the inside thigh, high to that femoral profunda, then goes upstairs with the roundhouse kick. Chaves loading up on the right hand. Maybe should have thrown the left in the face to cover it. Jab there from Krnjic.
Yeah, that's something we're not really seeing from Krnjic, is that jab. He's got a really nice jab, but he's just not using it so much. He likes to prefer to use the legs in that big left hand.
I'd like to see Chaves go first here as much as he can.
Yeah, Chaves hasn't really gotten out of first gear yet.
No. You're dead right there, Dragon. We know he's capable of so much more, Bruno Chaves. Allowing himself to get backed up. But you know what, he also told us before his first fight a few months ago that he likes to play a rope a dope. Another reason why they call him Muhammad Ali. There's no ropes, of course, when you've got a circle, but he does like to sit back against the perimeter, absorb punishment, and then come back.
Yeah, but as soon as Krnjic gets close, he's tying him up, right? So he's locking him up, and he's not really answering back. See right here, he's going back. See, he just kind of circled out, took the shot, walked away.
Chaves light on his feet, moving around. Good right hand there from Chaves to end the round. Two down and one to go. Wow. Chaves has power. I dare say more power in his hands than Krnjic has. Krnjic is placing the legs very well. We are going to go into the third round here, Dragon, and how do you score it, folks? Where are you watching?
Kad ideš, Brajo, idemo jaka i za isto ruku, ista noga, ista ruka. Kad je on, kad dođe ovde, kroše baci onda uje trofi.
Na vidite, 30 sekundi.
30 seconds.
Depois desse direto, tem que entrar cruzado.
It's same shit as before.
After the straight, you can move the hook.
It's same shit. He scare you. Kick his arm. Where is mouthpiece?
You hear the corner there of Chaves saying he's scared of you. Kick his arm.
Let's go, guys.
After the right hand, throw the hook. Give the punches company. Third and final round.
Guys, keep it clean. All right? Ready? Ready?
And touch gloves. Krnjic again on the front foot as he has been all fight. Who's going to go first? It's Krnjic with a high kick. Body shot, looking for the liver. Knee there from Chaves, and Olivier Cost breaks the front kick from Krnjic. You cannot catch and counter, though, under these kickboxing rules.
Yeah, I think that's a big part of Bruno's game, is to catch and counter. He keeps trying to catch the front kick as well. You can see by his hand placement. But you're not allowed to do that in one championship kickboxing rules. So he keeps going after that low kick. He's gonna catch Chaves low.
Chaves eats that left hand. Krnjic cuts off the movement. Bosnian steel goes to the body. High check there from Chaves. Hook off the right hand from Chaves. Krnjic tried to turn in the left knee. Chaves coming forward. I like that. Lumbers forward on his opponent. Throws the right hand down the center. Now on the outside again. Waiting for Krnjic to come to him.
Yeah, he knew that was coming. He cross-blocked it before Krnjic even threw it, but there was no answer behind it.
Time! Last one. No holding, okay?
Chaves definitely not moving as free-flowingly as we know he's capable of dragging.
Yeah, a lot of his past fights he's been able to, you know, utilize a very unorthodox style, but his activity is usually a lot higher. And now he's just not throwing as much. But to be fair, Krnjic is doing just enough to stay ahead. I'd like to see Krnjic do a little bit more too.
I agree. Krnjic had a very good opening round. Hasn't been as busy since though. Tried to stick him with the right hand there, did Chaves. 1 minute remaining in the fight. Chaves again, drawing Krnjic to the outside. Little knee on the inside there from Bosnian steel. Chaves has got to do more here. Is he playing possum a little?
Good head movement.
Go on.
You've got to ask the questions here of Bruno Chaves. Inside leg kick, which Krnjic was using well in the first round. Good right hand there. Two knees from Chaves. Chaves coming forward. 15 seconds on the clock now. Overhand right. That's more like it from the Brazilian. And a jab from Krnjic. Overhand right again. Thought about a jumping knee to Chaves. Blocks the high kick. Evades the right hand. Front kick from Krnjic. And a right hand on the bell. Bosnian steel puts the fist in the air. Did he do enough to win it?
There was a lot of activity coming from Krnjic. He pushed forward. He was aggressive, controlled the distance, and really froze Bruno in a lot of the exchanges. He was able to utilize hand combinations. He really threw a lot of that left kick. He did some good scoring up close. Had the consistent forward pressure, and I think that's going to be the most important category of our scoring for Ahmed Krnjic, just to control the distance, find his range, and keep applying the pressure and show that aggression.
We're about to find out the judges' decision. This was the final fight of our lead card. Our main card is now only 8 minutes away. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Ahmed.